Slow poker.
I have a career and a family, but also play poker, which doesn't leave me much time. So let's get to it.
Apparently, I'm in the Bahamas, about to play a high roller tournament where the winner gets over 3 million clams. Do I belong here? Absolutely. It's not because I won a contest. No. Battling the best poker players on the planet in a $25,000 buy-in tournament at a lavish Caribbean resort? Maybe that's just how slow rolls.
This Funyuns coupon expired last week.
After 3 hours of ups and downs, I peel pocket queens. Sure, this may look like 9-5 offsuit, but it's queens, because they put the kibosh on mid-hand filming, which means I gotta make do with the footage I've got. So do me a solid, and squint. Queens, right? Yeah, you see it. Totally queens. And look at this poker table. Gorgeous. But if you sprinkle in just the right amount of CGI... pristine. Facing a UTG raise to 1,000, I 3-bet to 3,000, and get a button cold call and a UTG call. Now, tournaments aren't my bag, so I have no experience with these chip denominations. Not unlike my 6-year-old at this art installation at the hotel, where it's clear she has no experience with rotary phones. Still, obviously I can calculate that there's 10,000 in the pot, so after this flop and a check and the words 10,000 on a loop in my brain, I bet 10,000.
Oops.
And when Button smooth calls my pot-sized misclick, I panic. Cause preflop cold call hands are often pocket jacks and pocket tens. And this flop is drywall dry. But hey, maybe he's got jacks. After I die a small death, I check, and Button bets a puny 5 grand. Sure, he could be milking me, but 6th pot? I will not be folding to that. And after this river, I check, and he bets an even more insulting 7,000, which I happily snap call as he angrily snap mucks. He claims he had ace-jack, which, if true, is quite a flop call against a pot-sized bet with a player behind. Not that I'm complaining. His loss of dignity is my gain in chips, of which I don't have real footage. So please enjoy this representation of my stack, courtesy of the breakfast buffet.
I got money stacked, my dirty club.
I've got jacks. A lovely Frenchman raises to 1K, and just because he's French and in the hijack doesn't mean I wave and say, "Hi Jacques." I'm not gonna be that American, making all the dumb French jokes. I'm above that, possibly. No promises. Instead, I twa bet to 2,000, and he calls. After this flop and a check, I bet 2.5K, and he min check raises to 5K. This sizing reeks of draw, but I don't notice the low SPDCR, so I make the mistake of just flatting. And after this turn, he jams his last 15K. Sure feels like I just let him pull ahead, and while it's a great price, and by the book that I haven't read, I'm supposed to call. Instead, I mutter something something ICM, and say, "Au revoir, Jacques Jacques." I then make an offer. He shows me his hand, and I give him free pastries that my kids baked at the hotel cooking camp. But he declines with some stereotypical French elitist bullshit excuse about, I don't know, living next to the best patisserie in the Alps. Okay, whatever, frere. Offer withdrawn. More haute cuisine pour moi.
Oh yeah. Oh. these are tray not married.
I've got 7-6 of clubs. And real footage from this actual hand. Fancy that. And I decide that since misclicking worked so well before, let's try it again here. And toss in a 1K chip for a min raise, but forget to verbalize the raise. Which means I've inadvertently limped. So after 5 hours without a single limped pot, I've started quite the party. As the button overlimps, small blind completes, and big blind checks. And after some visible confusion by me, the dealer rewards my blunder. 2 checks to me, I bet 1K, and big blind check raises to 3K. I almost feel bad, because if I were him, I'd probably rep the 7-2. I smooth call, and on this turn, he pots, and I call. And after this river, at first I think, "F me, not again." But then big blind gives up the charade, so I bet and he folds. And once again, slipping up leads to chipping up, which gets me thinking, maybe I should accidentally open limp every hand. Worked out that time? Yeah, new plan. I'm done with raisin. Oh, that's not what I meant. Please look at me. No, I promise, raisin forever. I've got ace-5 suited, and it's raisin time. The player to my left, who just sat down with a massive stack, flat calls from the small blind, which is weird. And on this flop, he donks for nearly pot, which is also weird. It's only later that I see this player making odd moves with odd holdings, placing odd bets in odd spots. And I should probably raise this donk and retake the betting lead, but I just flat, because I'm pretty sure I'm already ahead and can always turn more ahead. But after this jack and another large donk, I should stop hemorrhaging chips. Instead, I call, assuming the river will serve donk justice, premiering this fall on TNT. But the river, much like the US criminal justice system for pretty much anyone not white, f**ks me over. Donkey Donk Esquire shows a jack, and there's no need to show the other card. Calling out of position with trash, betting at the wrong time and still winning, soul owning a cash game crusher, slow poker just got robbied. And while I should be forever grateful to Mrs. Jade Liu for the inspiration that led me to write my first multi-platinum single and leave a lasting impression on my wife.
What are you wearing?
I just burned 12,000, so I will never speak to Robbie Liu again until I see her tomorrow. A couple deals later,
I've got a hand that makes me want to take a flamethrower to this place.
Sir, you're out of order.
Out of order? I'll show you out of order! You don't know what out of order is, Mr. Jack! King off!
I don't love raising this mediocre hand this early with so many players behind, but I'm still fuming that I Robbie Jade spewed. And hey, maybe I'll steal the blinds. No such luck as button calls. Hold on, did I say no such luck? Because I meant yes such luck. I bet 900, button snap calls, and big blind check raises to 5,000. So, first and foremost, okay. But also, wait, what big blind? Because, and yes, this is now a theme, I goofed again.
Once, twice, three times a fuck up.
That's right, I didn't notice big blind was in the hand. On account of my oversight, that means there's already been an out of turn bet and a call, which means the floor has to make a ruling. And while they debate whether big blind's raise can stand, I sit there, motionless, staring at the felt, praying they don't hear the song in my head.
Please, floor, let big blind check raise.
At first, the verdict is to prohibit the raise, but in the end, they reverse course and allow it. And luckily, I did capture footage of my live reaction.
Happy, happy dance, dance! Happy, happy dance!
At long last, the action's back on me. And sure, even though my children are at it again.
Now I find myself in kind of a fascinating spot because I've got what we in the industry call the stone cold nuts.
Who leaves peanuts in the freezer? Kids!
I just know the suckout's coming, so to play it safe, I let it go. JK off, JK off, JK off. You guys, come on. Anyway, I could flat, but the button may be on a flush draw, so the new price is 21K. Button folds, and big blind flat calls. Oh no. Well, I guess there's only one thing left to do, and that's to visualize the brick turn that we all know never, ever comes. Here we go. Brick! 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 And for what feels like the first time in history, the International Union of Bricklayers does its job. Big blind checks, I jam, and he tanks. He knows it, the table knows it, my mom knows it.
I don't.
Big blind even says out loud, I know you have the straight, but I can't fold. So he doesn't. And back to visualization we go.
No pair, no pair, no pair, no pair.
And it's time to make a meme. And now, the return of... Okay. I've got Ace-King, raised to 2K, and Donkey Donk Esquire, 3 bets to 6.5K. I pause, reflect, and re-raise to 21K. And DDE is DEEP in the tank. After a while, he winces, mutters, hee-haw, and folds. He tells me it's the first time he's ever folded jacks. I tell him there's a first time for everyone. Like how today, I saw the classiest sign ever made, just to tell you where to take a shit. The very next hand, I've got Ace-King. Raise and face a 3-bet from ACR Team Pro, Anna Marquez. And I have this irrational fear that no one would ever take seriously a second consecutive 4-bet. So I flat, whiff the 10-high flop, call a bet anyway, and lose to Ace 10. That pre-flop action from me, weak. Though nowhere near as weak as 10th place in Mario Kart? Stop it. No daughter of mine has to rely on a blue shell to take home the Mushroom Cup. No daughter of mine. I've got Ace-King. Lowjack raises, Hijack jams 11 bigs, I jam from the small blind, Lowjack folds, and despite the equity advantage on this flop, no dice this time. But hey, that's tournament poker. When you lose a flip, no one bats an eye. Eyes do bat, however, when they see this Poker Org headline. Don't double entendre me like that, Poker Org. Sure, last episode's thirst trap was creepy as all get out, but it was a joke. I'm not some deviant. Or am I?
I'm not.
I've got pocket tens. And there's a raise from UTG, but it's not your garden variety UTG. It's new addition to the table, Sam Greenwood. Sure, Sammy here may have 26 million reasons he's among the best around, so a case could be made I should be scared to play back at him. But I won that $20 tournament at Todd's house, so maybe he should be scared of me. Which is why I 3-bet, and Sam Greenwood calls. On this flop, he checks, I bet, and he calls. On a turn that's bad for my hand but good for my range, he checks, I size up, and he calls again. And on this river, Sam Greenwood glances at his stack. Greenwood! You green wouldn't. You green did it, Greenwood. And I am in the tank. His line here doesn't make much sense. And when that happens in a cash game, I tend to just flick it in. But I can't stop landing on Queen Jack of Clubs, where he calls flop with the gut shot and backdoor clubs, turns a club, and just gets there. And Queen Jack is my nemesis hand. In fact, I just told my son in the lobby that while I tend to be even keeled, when Queen Jack sucks out on me, I'm always angry. I know, there's a pretty good chance that Sammy Canada here is just airballing with a stiff ace of clubs, but I'd rather lose pretty big to a bluff than really big to Queen f***ing Jack. Either way, Sam, I will not be renewing my membership.
They say sometimes you're the hammer and sometimes you're the nail. Well, Sam Greenwood, this time you're the flaming whiskey and I'm the melting ball of chocolate.
What do you do when you're card dead? You tell him, problematic 80s film character.
Nothing! Absolutely nothing! Stupid! You're so stupid!
I begin day two with 45 big blinds, which is plenty, but am dealt trash for hours and hours. So after blinding down to less than 20 bigs, while it pains this cash game player, I spend the back nine of day two pushing or folding. Pocket nines in the cutoff? Shove. Steal the blinds. Suited ace on the button? Shove. Steal the blinds. Ace king under the gun? Shove. Steal the blinds. Lather, rinse, repeat. With only 12 big blinds left, button raises, small blind 3-bets, and I'm in the big blind with ace-queen. Presumably there's only one move here, but I text my wife to check, and she snap text back with this. Now this could be shorthand for daiquiris, but I think it's her way of telling me. Dealt ace-queen? Shove. If you say so, wife, if you say so.
I say so.
I call my wife to celebrate, but she's pretty incoherent after having knocked back 6 Delta Queen shoves.
Great call. Huge double up.
Jacks. Everybody!
After a long, short-stacked day two, it's time for day three. Glass half empty? I'm 242nd out of 255, and only have 11 bigs. Glass half full? I've made it this far in a field of 1,000, and am only 80 players away from at least a min cash of $35,000. So if I can just hang on, dacks are on me.
Everybody.
It's the very first hand of day three, and after the table fat stack raises, I peel ace jack. Okay, so listen. I have a career and a family, which doesn't leave me much time to study tournament poker, but I have played enough cash games to know that ace-jack could be the most premium I'll see for an hour. And I may not have an hour, so this could be my last chance to build a stack. I'd rather start amassing chips now, instead of blinding out like air gradually seeping out of a sad poker balloon. I could fold or go bold.
Everybody.
First hand.
Nice hand, Sam.
Thank you.
Well, I tried, and sure, I did bust only 78 players from the money, and $35,000 is $35,000. But I got it in good and didn't hold. No shame in that. Aces lose there. I outlasted scores of world-class poker players and other poker players. I got to throw shade at the main event champ, run into him 5 seconds later, and 5 seconds after that, bust. So, karma. I got to meet the funniest commentator in poker, and he got to meet me. I got to goof off with this piece of work, who's both hilarious and can't seem to find the off switch for pumping out children. I got to chat with this guy all the way to the airport, and he's kind of dreamy. I got to hang with that guy from The Wire, Billions, Breaking Bad, and above all, 1997's Broadway smash, Titanic the Musical. My son got to meet this guy a mere week before he commentated the big game. My daughter got to end me with a water gun. I got to spend a week with the best entourage in poker, and I got to play Rocket Launcher one too many times, wreck my back, and f*** me up for weeks. You know what? I'll take the W. And that'll do it for episode 21 of Slow Poker. Please like, subscribe, comment below, hit that notification bell, and don't forget that you knew me when. Until next time, this has been
Slow Poker.